Hi, this is Merrill with Tax Tutor. I wanted to talk about a very urgent and important matter that has to do with 2021 tax returns. But first, if you find value from this video, I would appreciate it if you would hit the subscribe button and subscribe for future updates. So what is going on with the child tax credit and 2021 tax returns? Well, when the tax law was passed earlier this year, it had a provision for the IRS to start sending out advanced child tax credits. The advanced child tax credits means that rather than claiming the credit on your tax return when you file it, they're actually going to start mailing you checks or making direct deposits into your bank account in advance of you filing a tax return. Now, that might sound great to start getting monthly payments from the government, from the IRS. However, there is a big caveat. There's a big warning that comes with that. And that is that when you are receiving a credit in advance of filing a tax return, it means that when you file that return, you're going to have less of a credit to claim. And that is either going to reduce the refund that you're going to receive on that return, or if you receive so much of a credit that it puts you into a taxable situation, you will have to owe tax to the IRS when you file your return. For me, that was a little alarming and a little worrisome that I could run into a situation where I owe tax to the IRS. So let's go through some of the numbers and how it works and discuss what can be done and how we can handle this credit. So first off, the child tax credit is increased. It started at $2,000. That's how it's been for the past several years. And the tax law that was passed this year increased that child tax credit. For children that are 5 and under in 2021, so we're talking about anybody at December 31st, if they're still 5 and under, then the child tax credit goes from $2,000 to $3,600. If that child is between the ages of 6 and 17, so at the end of 2021, they're 17 or younger, then the child tax credit increases from $2,000 to $3,000. Now, I have written some numbers here, and this means who gets that increased child tax credit. So it's for married filing joint. If you file a joint return, if you're married and file a joint return, and your income is under $150,000 for 2021, then you would get this increased child tax credit from $2,000 up to $3,600 for 5 and under, or from $2,000 up to $3,000 for children between the ages of 6 and 17. The $112,500 number is for head of household filers, and the $75,000 number is for single filers and for married filing separately. So the problem that we run into is that the IRS is now going to start sending advanced child tax credits, and it will use your 2020 tax return, or if you haven't filed your 2020 return yet, they will use your 2019 tax return. Now, here's a scenario. For 2020, I had a lot of clients that their income was down. We had COVID, we had a pandemic, things were shut down. Their income dropped. And their income drop would have put them below these thresholds, these levels. And so if the IRS looks at their 2020 return and they say, oh, hey, a married filing joint for 2020, they're under $150,000, we're going to send them an advanced child tax credit of $3,600 and $3,000 for their children. Now, here's the issue. Let's say in 2021, pandemic's subsiding, things are getting back to normal, incomes are going back up, and now income increases more than these threshold amounts. Well, those people will now lose the increase of the child tax credit, and they will now owe that back to the IRS, or it's going to reduce their refund that they would normally get. It puts them in kind of a tricky situation in that sort of instance. And so when your income goes over these thresholds, the $150,000 for married filing joint, the $112,500 for head of household, and the $75,000 for single and married filing separately, when it goes over those thresholds, you lose that additional. You lose the $1,600 for the children that are 5 or under, and you lose the additional $1,000 for children that are between the ages of 6 and 17. And then you fall down to this $2,000 level, which was the normal level. And that phases out when you get to incomes of $400,000 for married filing joint and $200,000 for all other filers. So that's head of household, single, married filing separate is the $200,000. So if, again, your income was lower in 2020 and now the IRS is using your 2020 return to send you this advanced child tax credit and your incomes are going over these limits or over these limits, you're going to have to pay that child tax credit back to the IRS when you file your return. So that's this note here that we have on repayment. So that's something to look out for and be cautious of. Now, there is a way to opt out of receiving the advanced child tax credit, and that is on irs.gov. And this is a great place to go for all questions and all this stuff, all this information. It's where I went to grab this information. There's a lot of information on there. But if you go to irs.gov, there is a link on there that says questions about the advanced child tax credit. If you click on that link, it's right on their main page. It will take you to a page with a button where you can opt out. And it also has a link in there for frequently asked questions. And so it would be beneficial to go through that and see what kind of questions they have answers for in there. You may have questions that I'm not able to answer in this video just because there is so much information on that website. So I would encourage you to go to irs.gov, click on that questions about the advanced child tax payment, and then if you feel like you want to opt out, so me personally, I decided to opt out. There's too many factors, too many variables, and I didn't want to get into my tax return and find out that I owed money to the IRS. That was not a good scenario in my case, so I just decided to opt out. If you're somebody that needs the money and you normally get a really large refund on your federal tax return, then I would say opting out probably not such a big deal, because now you're getting that advance payment earlier now. It's going to reduce your refund. You're not going to owe. But again, you'd have to be getting a pretty sizable refund in order to have that be an issue. So a couple of things as well. So this is the first year that they're doing this advanced child tax credit payment. And so since they're starting halfway through the year in July, they're actually only paying out half of these amounts. So if you get into a scenario where you don't opt out and you really wanted to, it's not going to be as bad because they're only going to pay half the amount. So for children that are 5 and under, this $3,600 payment is going to come in payments of $300 per month over the next 6 months. For children that are between the ages of 6 and 17, it'll be $250 a month that they're going to pay over the next 6 months. So you're only getting half of these amounts. Next year, we're going to have a full year. So in January, they're going to start paying out these full amounts. Again, if you don't opt out, you're going to start getting those full amounts. And by the time you get to file your 2021 tax return, you will not have any child tax credit on that return because the IRS had sent it out all in advance payments. Now, there are a number of issues with that. If your income goes up and you're not eligible for the payment, if a dependent moves out, if there's change in filing status, there could be a number of changes that happen and that puts you into a predicament and an issue with the IRS if they're sending you these payments. You also have to keep track of these payments. Supposedly, the IRS is going to send you a letter in January, but that happened this year with the stimulus payments. And when we tried to get that information from clients, it was difficult. Some clients couldn't remember. They had to go back to their bank accounts and figure it out. They still couldn't find it. We filed tax returns with incorrect information. It took months for the IRS to sort it out. It turned into a bit of a mess. And those was only two stimulus payments that came last year that we had to put on 2020 tax returns. Now, this year, we're getting 6 monthly payments, and taxpayers are going to have to go and figure out how much the IRS sent them, or hopefully hold on to the letter that the IRS sent them. The following year, you're going to be getting 12 monthly payments that you got to keep track of, and you have to report on your return so that the IRS can true that up. So again, personally, I felt it was better just to opt out of it and deal with it on my return like I do in any normal tax year. And so to opt out, you go to that irs.gov, you click on the questions about the advanced child tax credit, and there's a nice button there that says opt out, and you can click on that. Here's the tricky part though. You have to do it, if you're married filing jointly, if you file a joint return with your spouse, both of you have to opt out. If only one of you opt out, the IRS will send you half of those payments. And so then you're gonna have to try to figure out how to true up half the payments that come. So both my wife and I went and opted out. You have to have an account with the irs.gov. Being a CPA and accountant, I had one, so I was able to log in very quickly because I'm always logging into the IRS website for certain things. And so I was able to do it quick. It's a couple questions you answer and you're out of it. It's very simple. My wife, on the other hand, did not have an IRS.gov account and had to set it up. And it was a bit of a pain. It took her a while. We started on the computer, and then it required identity verification that required a picture of a driver's license or a passport. So then she had to transfer and try to do it through a tablet or a phone. And then by that time, she'd already started the account. Anyway, it was a bit of a mess. So my recommendation is that if you do choose to opt out and you set up that IRS.gov account, to do that on some kind of a mobile device that is able to take a picture or have a picture of your driver's license and your passport, or your passport that you can upload to that site, just to make it easier on you to do that. So again, this is just kind of a quick primer and a warning about what's coming up with this child tax credit. The payments are going to start July 15th is when the first payments come out, and the deadline to opt out of those is Monday, June 28th, which is coming up very, very quickly. Some of you may be watching this video after that June 28th deadline, which means that you're already going to get the July payment. But that's okay, you can opt out anytime. So as long as you opt out, you know, if you choose to opt out, as long as you opt out when you watch this video, then you can stop those payments, those future payments, from coming. The next one will come in August, and I believe the deadline to opt out of that is toward the beginning of August, August 3rd or somewhere around there, if I remember right. So anyway, there's deadlines for doing that. You may already be too late to opt out of that first one. So that first payment that you receive will already be reducing your refund coming back next year, or cause you to pay tax depending on your tax situation. But yeah, go to IRS.gov, look at the questions there, and feel free to subscribe to this channel, and we'll give updates as things go on. So thanks.